Hello YouTube, this is another video review from Super Apple Forever. In this video, I'll be reviewing Microsoft Office 2008. I also have a video review on Microsoft Office 2004 and Microsoft Office 2011. So this is Microsoft Office 2008. This is the student home edition. It's not in the easiest Word processor to use. If you have 2008, I would strongly recommend upgrading to Office 2011. I have it right here. It's a lot better. It really is. It's a really big improvement. If you have any other questions about that, I also have a video review, like I said, on 2011. Okay, so let's look at Microsoft Word first. See, you can see the difference. That's the 2011, this is 2008. It takes a really long time to open, and I have a pretty fast computer, and it takes a long time to open. Microsoft Word doesn't, 2011 doesn't take as long as 2008 takes. So here it is. It's just, you know, a basic Word processor. You haven't. So here's the toolbox. I don't really like the toolbox. I think it gets in the way and it's kind of annoying. I think that Microsoft actually just threw this version together, and a lot of people didn't like it. So that's why they made such big and big improvements on 2011. But yeah, you have all your stuff here. Fonts. Pictures, things like that. One thing I really hate about this, though, is that when you open it up, it has this border around it. It doesn't open in a full window, so I always have to resize that. It's kind of annoying to do. It may not bother some people, but it bothers me for some reason. So I'm just going to play around with it a little bit to show you guys. This is highlighting. You can change the color. Change the font size. So yeah, another thing that you can do is customize the toolbar. There's a way to make it look kind of like 2011 by inserting a toolbox here, and I'm trying to find it. That kind of makes it look a little bit like 2011. It kind of looks like it, but I still like 2011 a lot better. It's a lot easier to use, and it's just it's a little bit more stable, and it opens faster. There's just a lot of new features. Here's PowerPoint 2008. For some reason, it opens faster than Word, even though it's a bigger program. So this, with 2011, it has more themes, and it has more features. Here's the toolbox again. With 2011, kind of has the same interface as Keynote. That's iWork 09 from Apple. So yeah, just basic stuff here. You can customize this to make it look a little bit more like 2011. You can play around with that. You just need to right click and then customize toolbars and menus. This is Excel. So yeah, this is just a basic data thing. I don't really use Excel, but I know a lot of people do. This is the 2011 one looks a lot better. It's a whole chart. It's not these different pages. It looks a lot better, and everything's down here, like I said, and it just looks a lot better. The last one is Entourage. With 2011, the name was changed to Outlook. I don't use this though. I use Mac Mail. I like Mac Mail a lot better a lot more because it's just easier to use, and I don't really need all the features that come with this program. I just send emails, so I really don't need all the features. So yeah, that's about it. There's some more tools in here. Remove office, things like that. And then there's more tools in here. There's some organizing tools. There's some, so there's just a few little programs in here. So that's about it. I highly recommend upgrading to Office 2011. I got it off of a torrent, and if you don't know what a torrent is, I have a video on that too. But I got mine off of a torrent, and I have the business edition. I really like it. It's a lot easier to use, and it's a lot more stable and better than 2008, especially 2004. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask me. You can either ask me in the comments or send me a private message. Either one's fine. So thanks for watching. Please like and please subscribe.